se você me aceitaria.
All right, welcome guys. So Brigitte here from Freedom Move Dance School and co-creator of Kizomba. So I like to think about Kizomba a little bit differently, I guess, than most people. So one thing that I've been thinking a lot about lately is levels in Kizomba. So what do I mean by levels? So this is a term that I got from hip-hop dance. So they talk about levels depending on basically the height of their body in space. So in hip-hop, like, you have the b-boys that are like going right down to the floor, which is not something that we have in Kizomba unless you're doing tricks. But we're not going to talk about tricks today, but just our regular, more regular levels. So basically in Kizomba, because it's kind of a subtle dance, that your levels have really, really small increments between them. So just bear with me, and if you're interested, yeah, just keep watching. So levels in Kizomba really allow you to make things like the five basics feel completely different. It also allows you to express a whole lot of musicality, even if you don't know a lot of steps. So it's very, very useful. Yeah, maybe visually it's not that different, but the feeling you get is like very, very, very different. So they're, to me, very, very interesting techniques, and they're not that hard to master. I mean, like anything else, practice really definitely helps. So in Kizomba, there are two types of level. First of all, there are what I would call straight hip levels, so where your two hip joints are at the same height, and then there's levels where you have one hip that's lower than the other. So the first, to me, I'm gonna go from highest to lowest. I'm going to say before I start that the more extreme ones, they're not very extreme in Kizomba, so the two levels where we're the highest and the two levels where we're the lowest would be the ones that are used the least, because they're the least comfortable levels to stay in for a long time. So, and then the four levels in the middle would be the one that you would use the most, where like the fourth level would be like your most used level. So the first level, the highest level in Kizomba, to me, is when usually both partners or the lead lifts to follow at the highest height on her toes that she can go. So I don't have a great flexibility, so I don't go that high myself, but that's the highest that I personally can go. So obviously you don't want to dance the whole dance like this because it's a little straining, but it can, and it is mostly used not traveling, but just as a musical accent to hit the beat in the music. You go up and down. Sometimes you'll travel a little bit, but most of the time it's going to be on the spot. So that would be your first level. So the hips are again are level, your both feet up. To me, the second level would be when we would have a slight lift of the heel. So not all the way up, just a little bit off the floor. And to me, there's two variations of this. So one of them is when the weighted leg is the one that has the lift. So why do we use this? So pivots and ochos mostly. So we would make sure that we lift the leg so that we can pivot and turn, right? So we have to be on the ball of our foot to pivot. The other one would be more for musicality, styling purposes, where your weight would be on a straight leg, and instead of going down, we would lift the hip up, over. So we could play with something for musicality with that. So that level does exist. And then we go into the third level, which to me is just basically standing straight, mostly with 50-50% weight. So our hips again are straight, both legs are straight, so we're not going up or down. So this is part of the basic flow of Kizomba. So if we're doing our basic one, we have a fraction of a second where we're at our 50-50. Or when we're walking, it's the same thing. We have a moment where we're 50-50. So we can basically take that moment, so stop the follow at that moment and play with that 50-50. Most of the time it would be for musicality purposes, so we can do like micro movements where we can twist our hips at that height. So something we could also block and just do something with the upper body. In our 50-50 here, for example, we can do some micro movements forward and back, just like rocking the body, right? Those are your kind of choices in 50-50. Then the fourth one, the fourth level would be, to me, like your most used level. And of course, it goes hand in hand with the third level because we do have the 50-50 in the middle of it every step. So that is, of course, our basic Kizomba walk, where we have one leg more or less straight, depending on the style you're using, and then a bent knee on the other one, and also the hip down. So this is used in your basic walk, it's used in your basic one, it's also used in your basic two. So basically all your basics. Also, if we're doing saída variations or whatever you're doing as a style, a turn pattern, you're using those levels every step. So basically going from a hip down to your 50-50, back again to your hip, one hip going down. So in this, we have basically the walking. So there's also some body movements, so like Tarashinya, Taraxa movements that use the basic one as a foundation. So for example, the figure eights would be a twisting of the hips on a fourth level. In kids, right? And then does I have anything else? Yes. So another similar thing, but where the weight disbursement is different. So usually on this level, we have our weight on our straight leg and like we're traveling our other leg without weight on it until we get to our 50-50. But in this case, we have what some people call the kickstand, where we put some weight, like maybe 30% of our weight, on a popped heel, and then we tense up the leg. So we use this a lot for kind of stiff movements, micro movements, and also for like, you know, kind of, or we can also do it in the front, it would work better in the front. We can also pop the front knee, so also these type of movement that we'll see, kind of use though that height. But it basically allows for different feelings, different grooves. Then we have the fifth one, which I call, I don't know if I've ever heard someone call it that, but I call it suspension. So suspension to me is when we have both knees slightly bent and our hips straight. So we're not yet in Tarashinya position, we're not low enough, we're just very slightly bent. And we're using like the push in the floor to kind of go up and over very slightly. And it's a small step, it's to kind of feel a different flow in the music. We're not dancing really to the beat. And it allows for this the follow to have space in our hips to do some movements, maybe some of these, while the lead is doing so those kinds of movements. So to me, that's what I call suspension. It's used for micro movement, flow, musicality, body movements. So to me, the sixth one. So the sixth level is your basic Tarashinya level. So to me, the Tarashinya position is when you have your fourth position, so one knee bent, one leg straight, and then we just meet the straight leg, and we're now at 50-50. So it's not a huge bend in your knees, so we have one knee bent, and you meet it, and this would be your typical Tarashinya position where you can do all your hip circles, your rolls, your pops, whatever, your hips going up and down, right? So a lot of your Tarashinya, Taraxa movements would be done out of that position. They are also sometimes used for stiff movements, so more in this realm. Or, you know, some micro movements. Also, sometimes in Taraxo, we would use like to move ourselves in that position, does exist. it's a little different because we need to use the floor to give the weight transfers versus like the hips telling us and the weight placement telling us. And then the seventh one to me is an overbend of one of the knees in from our Tarashinya position. So we have, we'll do it from here. So we have our basically Tarashinya position, we're here. And then we choose to overbend to accent something, maybe to give us some space for a little bit bigger movement, for some accent sometimes, right? And we can use them in the front, in the back. They're done, used often for body rolls or butt roll situations. And usually it's something kind of we want to accent in the music. Then our last and final one would be an overbend of both knees. So this one would be, again, the one we usually don't use as much, although there's a lot of people that overuse this because they overbend in their Tarashinya position. And that gets really tiring on the legs, and also it makes your hip move, like your hips can move too much in that position. So we're in a Tarashinya position, then we would overbend. I mean, we could even just drop as a musical accent, right? There's a lot of things like that we could do. But you don't want to spend too much time in an overbend on both knees. Just like an overbend on one knee, you don't want to spend too much time in because it's tiring. And it also doesn't look as clean. So that's all your positions. So again, just with those eight positions, you can do so many things. Even if you only know those eight positions and how you use them in the five basics, that's already like a really interesting dance. So yes, like it's, I do teach, you know, patterns and foundations and different figures and ways to walk around with your partner, but all those little tiny changes in basically your levels, your height, and your dancing can create so many little intricacies to express the music, and it really keeps things interesting for your follow, even if you're not doing anything very complicated, because all your basics are always different because you're doing them in different levels, right? So I find it's really super interesting, both as a lead and follow, to really play with those concepts. And you can see that, like, because the different levels, sometimes your hips are stiff, sometimes your hips, one is down, one is up. And then you have different energies like up and over or down and up and all those things. So depending on what your instrument you're listening to in the music, what song it is and what's the energy, the feeling of that song, you can really express like a whole range of things. So it's, to me, really interesting in that way, because it's like a really simple way to express a lot of musicality. So I hope you enjoyed it. And I've never heard anyone talk about the levels in Kizomba exactly that way, so I hope it makes you think about certain things in a slightly different way. And yeah, maybe I'll do a video dancing with someone if I can find someone to do it with in the next few days, so that you can better see kind of what all this can look like. And hope you enjoyed it, and we'll be back later for another video.